Welcome to another edition of the SSC TV3 News. We are more than news. We have been televising news, events, and archives that are the lifeblood of the St. John community for more than 40 years. And at the present time, we have 450 subscribers and 1,049 videos on YouTube. And we also have hundreds of viewers on Facebook. Today is Friday, April the 2nd of 2021. I am David Cutright, along with Martha Cutright, and we will be bringing you the show today. This is a live view of the city park at about 6:30 p.m. The sky is partly cloudy. The winds are out of the south at 27 miles per hour. The temperature is 66 degrees, and the humidity is 27%. And these are the features that will be on the show today: Friends, Crafts and Flowers, and the Milk Barn Market. We televise this program live each Friday at 6:30 p.m., but if you miss the show, it will be uploaded to YouTube right after the show so that you can watch it at your convenience. To do this, just put the sscTV3.org information in your browser's URL line. Occasionally, due to program conflicts, the news will be delayed or rescheduled. Please share our news, features, and programming on your social media. This will help us grow and enable us to serve you better. We also welcome press releases. Just bring them by the studio or send them to sscTV3@gmail.com. Also, if you would like to be a sponsor of our news or governmental telecasts, send your request to sscTV3@gmail.com and we will set you up. Your advertisement will run on the governmental telecasts, the TV3 News, and the TV3 Bulletin Board, which runs 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. And to keep you up to date with the latest in public service announcements, it is updated daily, typically after 5 p.m., to capture business notices that are posted at the end of the day. Also, the Bulletin Board now includes birthdays and anniversaries. If you would like to add, remove, or correct one, please call 620-253-0037. Here now are some of our sponsors. Please let them know that you appreciate their support of our local news. And now it is time for some school announcements. Preschool is available for all 3- and 4-year-olds. To be eligible, however, students must participate in a screening process. The screening is scheduled for Wednesday, April the 7th from 9 a.m. to 12 noon in the community room of the Ida Long Goodman Memorial Library. Appointments are required. Call 620-672-7500 extension 1203 or email sandra.espino@sckSEC.com. More information is available on the school Facebook page. On Wednesday, April the 7th, St. John High School will be hosting the League Forensics Meet. Because of this, students in grades 7 through 12 will be dismissed at noon. Elementary students will be in school all day. The annual Community Service Day will be Wednesday, April the 14th, from 12 noon to 3 p.m. High school students will be helping with yard work, cleaning, picking up limbs, or other odd jobs. Work requests are available at the Ida Long Good Memorial Library, the St. John City Office, the Sandy Lane Shepherd Center, the Sunflower Senior Center, SJ and Bank of Kansas, St. John Post Office, the USD 350 District Office, and High School Office. And at this time, they are needing more projects. The monthly Board of Education meetings will be in the community room of the Ida Long Good Memorial Library until further notice. The meetings are open to the public, but masks will be required as social distancing cannot be maintained. These meetings will be telecast live on cable channel 3, as well as uploaded to ssctv3.org. The next meeting will be Monday, April the 12th at 7 p.m. These meetings are sponsored by the City of St. John. Although this business specializes in fresh-cut flowers and potted plants, there is a plethora of other products on the floor. Last Saturday, there was a Stafford County open house. One of the businesses showcased that day was Friends Crafts and Flowers on the east edge of Stafford. I decided to check it out.
I'm Brenda Fuller, and I am the owner of Friends Crafts and Flowers. For those of you that don't maybe know the history, my mother and I actually started this business together back in 1978. So I don't know, I haven't done the arithmetic lately, but I think that's going on 43 years. So I would hope most of you are familiar, but anyway, if you're not, we'd welcome you in at any time. The main part of our business is actually fresh cut flowers and our potted plants, but we do weddings, funeral work, of course, and any kind of custom work also. But one of my favorite things is changing of the seasons, because I like to get out the new seasonal things. We sell a lot of seasonal decor. We sell garden flags. Of course, we'll have the silk arrangements and bouquets and things done in the seasonal colors. We also have a lot of gift items. We sell jellies, honey. We have honey. Actually, if you're familiar with the bee people, that's my brother that has the bee farm. And so, but we do have his honey here. If you ever can't reach them, you can come here and get it. Somebody asked about classes. With COVID, we haven't had classes. We are looking at starting some of those again, but that will probably be in the future.
And now for some city announcements. The City of St. John now has a new website. It is stjohnkansas.org. It is still in early development, so check it out and let the city office know about problems, textual mistakes, and omissions. The developer is currently working on the dead links. The citywide cleanup will be Monday, April the 12th through Saturday, April the 17th. Have your items curbside in separate piles by 8 a.m. Monday morning. There will be no second trips. Please be aware of what will and will not be picked up. The will not pick up list is on the TV3 bulletin board. The following are the city council members whose terms will expire in 2021. Mark Bryant for mayor, Ross Fisher and Isai Macias, council members. File with the county clerk by June 1st for these positions. And now for some around the square announcements. The 2021 Jubilee will be May the 28th and 29th. If all goes well, the newly renovated Mosley Memorial Fountain will finally be rededicated. Jubilee t-shirts are available from an online supplier. Go to stjohnjubilee.itemorder.com/sale to get yours. Jubilee vendors are also needed. The cost is $30 per booth, and payment secures the spot. First come, first served. Visit the Around the Square Facebook page for an application or stop by the city office. TV3 will also be sponsoring the class floats, $100 for first place, $75 for second place, and $50 for third place. Since there was no parade last year, the theme for this year's class floats is on the road again. Actually, the parade will be on the street again, but on the road again sounds better and provides for more float options. Judging will be on theme representation and execution. And now for some county announcements. The COVID-19 update is very good. As of March the 31st, there were zero active quarantine orders and zero active cases. Stafford County Recycling is located at 400 South Exchange. It is open Monday through Friday from 7:30 a.m. to 4:30 p.m. and normally unlocked during weekends. There are also 10 bins outside for your use. Here now are more of our sponsors. Please let them know that you appreciate their support of our local news. And here now is a new feature under our different hot headings of announcements. It is the Shepherd Center announcements. The Shepherd Center is now open for business with morning hours of 9:30 a.m. to 11:30 a.m. and afternoon hours of 1 p.m. to 3 p.m. The April newsletter was mailed last week. This will be a monthly newsletter. If you know of someone who would like one, please call 620-549-6351. The April Lunch and Learn will be Wednesday, April the 28th at noon at the Stafford County Annex Community Room. Teresa Miller will be speaking about the CORE program and how participants can work with the St. John Seniors. A light lunch will be provided by SSC TV3 and Cut Right Productions. Please call 620-549-6351, the Sandy Lynn Shepherd Center's office, if you plan to attend. Seniors 60 and older should have received a survey from SWACA about needs for our Stafford County seniors. If you did not get a survey, pick one up at the Sandy Lynn Shepherd Center office, or we can mail you a survey to you if you call the office at 620-549-6351. As a service to Stafford County seniors, volunteer drivers will take you to medical appointments within a 100-mile radius of St. John. This service will be shared with a ministerial alliance. Call 620-549-6351 for more information. And now for some public service announcements. Trudy Del Fox Risley, age 72, passed away on March the 31st. This time, services are pending. The children of Vanita and Virgil Gatton will be celebrating their lives of their parents on Saturday, April the 10th at 10 a.m. at Trinity Community Church in Hudson. There will be a retirement reception for Jim Lakey. It will be Sunday, April the 11th from 2 p.m. to 4 p.m. at the Stafford County Annex. There will also be a farewell reception that day for Jim and Sybil Ronan as they prepare to move to Tennessee. It will be at the First United Methodist Church from 2 p.m. to 4 p.m. The Sunflower Senior Activities are going strong. The daily schedule is Monday through Thursday from 9:15 to 3:15 p.m. and Friday from 9:15 a.m. to 1:15 p.m. For friendship meals, call 620-352-1802. Also, these weekly menus are posted on the TV3 bulletin board. This service is also in great need of drivers to deliver these meals. If you can spare an hour shortly before noon, please call. Coffee, conversation, and snacks are Tuesdays and Thursdays from 10 a.m. to 11 a.m. The senior supper will be Monday, April the 5th at 6 p.m. Bring a side dish to go with barbecue food. TFAP will be Tuesday, April the 27th from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. And finally, bingo will be Wednesday, April the 28th from 1:30 p.m. to 3 p.m. Bring a candy bar to play. There will be prizes and refreshments. Many times we think a business has to be large to offer great product. But this is not always true, as you will see. This little market has a lot to offer.
Last Saturday, there was a Stafford County open house. One of the businesses showcased that day was the Milk Barn Market north of Stafford. I decided to check it out.
It's really hard to find high-quality meat that is healthy. The grass-fed beef has higher healthy fats and lower saturated fats. It also has no added hormones. Ours doesn't. So a couple of years ago, we came up with the idea to open a store. We are located here in the Milk Barn, which actually was a milking barn. The milk parlor's in the back. This room is actually the milk room where they had the tank and so forth. We renovated it in December and January and then opened the beginning of February. We are typically open Tuesdays from 3 to 6, Thursdays from 3 to 5:30, and Saturdays 8:30 to 2. We have a Facebook page. You can find us at the Milk Barn Market on Facebook. You can find us on Shop Kansas Farms. And then we also have a website, themilkbarnmarket.com. You can also call us and make an appointment to meet here if those hours don't work for you. In fact, my husband is willing to meet you next week when we are closed. We have all grass-fed beef, ground beef, hamburger patties, roast, T-bone steaks, minute steaks, ribeye steaks, KC strips, sirloin steaks, bacon-wrapped steaks, brisket, stew meat, soup bones, ribs, and liver. We also have raw milk, wheat berries for grinding into flour, and I can also grind them for you. I have a grinder that I keep here. And then we have chicken and duck eggs. We have multiple crafty items. We have handmade soap from milk, two different varieties, and my daughter, middle daughter and I both make that together. We also have what we call farmer's hand cream, which is a very moisturizing cream. We have some Burt Braggs wooden signs made from barn wood, and some tea towels and apron and other crafty items available.
A market with a mission: healthy foods at great prices.
Please help our channel better serve you with quality and informative programming. We have a lot of good stuff happening in our area, and it is our goal to bring these activities to those who cannot attend. If you have items that need to be announced on TV3 or have an event that would benefit from video coverage, we would like to hear from you. Give us a little notice and we will be there. Just call 620-253-0037. Join us again next Friday at 6:30 p.m. for another edition of the TV3 News. Thank you for watching. God bless and help the USA.